let us consider the concept of electric field. So what is this electric field? Electric field is defined as the space surrounding a charge in which its influence is felt. Take any charge. Up to what extent surrounding the charge, the influence of this charge is felt. For example, if I take plus Q here. So imagine up to certain extent, say this area, the influence is present. Influence means you keep another charge. See, up to what maximum distance this charge can exert a force on the other. That maximum distance is the space. The space surrounding the charge in which its influence is felt is called electric field. Normally, if I use inverse square law, F inversely proportional to D square. When D is infinity, F becomes zero. That means when two charges are separated by infinity distance only, the force between them is zero. This indicates the influence of a particular charge will always extend up to infinity distance. Therefore, theoretically I can take electric field extends up to infinity. Because inverse square law suggests only at D is infinity, the force becomes zero. So electric field always extends up to infinity. Right. So how to imagine the electric field? Electric field is always represented with lines of force. So what are these lines of force? How to define a line of force? A line of force is an imaginary line or a curve. It may be line or a curve along which a positive charge can travel freely. So in the electric field, you just leave a positive charge and see what is the path along which it travels. The path, it may be straight line path or a curved path. An imaginary line or a curve along which a positive charge can travel freely is called a line of force. So along that curve, a positive charge is traveling. So the positive charge travel path itself is called a line of force. Is a line, imaginary line or a curve along which a positive charge can travel freely. So what are the properties of these lines of force? So if I take positive charge, a positively charged body is assumed. So I am taking another positive charge to define line of force. So place a positive charge. So definitely this plus, this repels. So the second positive charge will move away from this one. Where or in which direction will place, same kind of phenomena you can expect. So lines of force from a positive charge, they appears to be diverging. So lines of force diverge at the positive charge. If I take a negative charged body, if I take any positive charge here, this positive is attracted. So along any direction, if you place the negative positive charge, it shows attraction. That means negative charge lines of force are converging. So electric lines of force diverge from the positive charge and converge at the negative charge. Concentration of lines of force indicate strength of the field. More the number concentrated, suppose if I say lines of force are like this. So here the field strength is more. Here the field is more strong field or strong. But here if I take weak field. So concentration of lines of force indicate the strength of the field at that point. At the strong field points, they concentrate more. At the weak points, they concentrate less. So distributed more. Now suppose, if I take a tangent drawn at any point on the line of force, say this is a line of force. If I draw a point tangent here, So at this point, the tangent drawn at this point gives the field direction. Tangent drawn at any point on the line of force gives the direction of electric field at that point. Electric field is a vector quantity, so it has direction. Therefore, the direction is denoted by the tangent drawn at any point on the line of force. In any field, if the lines of force are parallel, then the field is said to be uniform field. The electric field is uniform if the electric lines of force are parallel to each other. Suppose if I say the lines are represented like this, these are lines of force, then the field is said to be non-uniform field. Any shape. So in uniform field, the lines of force are equidistant parallel lines. And non-uniform field, the lines of force are curves, any curves that gives the line of force direction. So in the case of magnetic lines of force, they are closed curves, because in magnetism the line of force always travel from north to south in air, but inside the magnet south to north, so they are said to be closed curves. But whereas in electric case, let us say this is a positively charged particle, so line of force like this, negative line of force towards, so these are said to be open curves. Magnetic lines of force are closed curves, whereas electric lines of force are open curves. The reason is, in magnetism, poles always exist in pair. You don't have isolated north pole or isolated south pole, but in electricity we have isolated charge exist. Due to this reason, the electric lines of force are considered to be open curves, but magnetic lines of force closed curves. In air they move from north to south, inside the magnet they move from south to north. Okay, so when the electric field is represented with lines of force, how to calculate the magnitude? This is called intensity of electric field. Intensity of electric field. It is defined as the force experienced by unit positive charge placed at that point in the electric field. For example, in the electric field, I want to calculate the intensity. So let us take, I want to calculate the intensity of electric field due to this plus Q, say at a distance D. Here my interest. So intensity of electric field is defined as the force acting on unit positive charge placed at that point. Here I am interested to calculate what is the strength of the field, what is the intensity. So place unit positive charge here. The force acting on this unit positive charge gives intensity at this point. That is, force 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into, this is capital Q, this is 1 divided by d square. So this is what we call intensity, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by d square. So intensity at d distance from the given charge Q is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by d square. Now suppose if I consider this is a plus Q charge. Let us place another Q charge here. Instead of unit, take Q charge. The equation for force is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught times capital Q into small q by d square. But already we proved E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by d square. Therefore, F can be written as EQ. So at any point, if the intensity of electric field is E, then the force acting on charge Q placed at that point is F is equal to EQ. From this, E can be taken as F by Q. Therefore, unit for E, SI system, force is Newton, C is Coulomb, Newton per Coulomb, or we can also use another one, volt per meter. Volt per meter or Newton per coulomb is the unit of intensity of electric field. It is a vector. Reason: it is the force acting on unit positive charge placed at that point. So place unit positive charge here and calculate the force. Since I am calculating the force and force is a vector, so intensity of electric field at any point is considered to be a vector. Then what is the direction of this vector? It is always in the direction of force on unit charge. Unit positive charge. So place the unit positive charge and see what is the direction of force. The direction itself gives the intensity of electric field direction. Now, for example, take a positively charged body. Here I am interested to calculate intensity E. So first thing, place unit positive charge. This is plus, this is plus, so it experiences a repulsive force. So intensity is also in this direction. Now suppose if I take a negative charge, so again at this point I am interested to calculate E. So place again unit positive charge. This is negative, this is positive, so it attracts unit positive charge, unit positive, therefore force is like this. So E is also towards negative charge. So due to positive charge, intensity of electric field is always away, and due to negative charge, the intensity of electric field are always towards. Now in the uniform electric field, if I use the word uniform, already we told lines are, electric lines of force are equidistant parallel. In the uniform electric field, E is constant. At every point, the value of E remains the same. It is constant both in magnitude and direction. The intensity of electric field at every point is constant in magnitude and direction. Then we can say the field is uniform. For example, at a place, a uniform field is like this. If I place a positive charge here, what is the direction in which this charge moves? So according to F is equal to EQ, here E into plus Q, because I am placing unit positive charge. So this is plus E into Q. In vector notation, this can be written as F bar is parallel to E bar. That means a positive charge experiences force in the direction of the electric field. This is electric field direction, so positive charge also experiences force in the same direction. Suppose if I take a negative charge, so place a minus Q here. Now according to F is equal to EQ equation, here Q is negative, so minus EQ, that means F bar anti-parallel to E bar. That means a negative charge experiences force opposite to the field direction. This is field direction E bar. This is F bar. So F bar is like this. So in any uniform electric field, a positive charge experiences force in the direction of the field, whereas a negative charge experiences force opposite to the field direction.